And I remember, I don't know if it was Halloween or it was Jason. I'm pretty sure it was Halloween.
Friday the 13th.
It was one of the Halloweens. Michael Myers' house, right? And then I think it was one of Bus Rhymes was on it.
Yes,
I might be mistaken.
It was.
Where these kids decided they wanted to spend the night in Michael Myers' house.
I think it was a dare.
Yeah, it might have been a dare. I mean,
the fuck, like, you're gonna dare to go into some killer's house just for like what, a whole night or a week?
It was a couple days, and I mean, you guys are idiots, and why you were surprised when he popped up is beyond me, because I would have been out that door.
But first of all, like, you going to, first of all, you're trespassing, getting on someone's house.
It's a killer's house, mind you.
And then you just expect, why the hell is he here? Like,
shit. Yeah, I mean.
If I was Michael Myers, I'd be like, why the hell are you here?
Yeah, right, yeah. See, I don't blame him for killing them. I mean, I would be mad as hell. You know, I'm coming back from, you know, being shot at, like, a shitload of times. You know, coming back from the dead, basically, to a house filled with hormonal teenagers who are knocking boots on my bed, you know?
Man, I just want to sleep, and then I got teenagers screwing in the back of
screwing in the bathroom, screwing in the kitchen,
in the closet,
screwing on the stairs, trapped in the closet. It's just getting out of hand.
I just wanted to change clothes.
And I've seen, like, you know, in the Halloween movies, Friday the 13th movies, these dumb niggas, they walk up to the killers and start asking questions like, you know, hey man, are you okay? You know, what the hell are you doing with that knife? Hey, you know, back up. You know, run. Yeah, don't ask questions with a guy with a mask and a knife in his hand. You asking for trouble.
He's not gonna ask you questions like, why are you in my house? He's just gonna kill you. Like,
there's nothing to it. You see, you hear trouble, you run.
But like I was going on, you have your teenagers that have sex. Let me just start with them, because I think this is like when you're most vulnerable. Okay, these kids already know you're not, like Quinn said, demon. You already know you're in the killer's house or area, and you already gonna make yourself vulnerable. And when you're having sex, you are the most vulnerable. I mean, you're naked. I think it's even worse than being in the shower, because you can't see all around you. I mean, when you're on the bed, of course the guy's on top. He's gonna be doing the girl, or the girl's on top, doesn't matter. The guy's gonna die first anyway. I think that was an example. I think Friday the 13th, having sex on top of a bed, where does Jason strike? Under the bed. I mean, it's perfect.
Of your ass around the corner is where that knife goes.
It's absolutely perfect. I mean, he timed it so right. Straight through. See, he knows he went to school. He knows exactly what he's doing. These teenagers, on the other hand, if that was me, this is how I would do it. I would look around the place. I mean, I'd have my buddy watch me while I was having sex.
Your buddy.
And then I would look under the bed. I'd make sure my buddy went under the bed, so just in case Mr. Jason decides, let me go under the bed, guess who's there to award me?
That's right. See, now what I would do was, I'd be butt naked, right? But I still have my shoes on, tied, ready to go. I'd be fucking the girl, and if I even suspect that there's something wrong, like even if I hear an ant, you know, tapping his little feet on the ground, I'm out. No questions asked, no hesitations, no nothing. Just get out of there. And every 3 seconds, you know, I get, you know, 3 seconds of good fucking. And then, stop. Jump back, look out the dome. Look around the corner.
Look under the bed.
Look out the window. Call my friend to see what's going on downstairs, because I heard some rustling down there. I don't think those are potato chips. I think someone's in the house. You know.
As soon as I saw him, I mean, I'm just dropping the girl and going.
Right, yeah.
I don't care if you're my girlfriend. I mean, I need to keep myself alive. Safety first.
Drop and go.
Even though I'm not using the condom, but safety first.
Wait, if we're fucking in some forest or abandoned warehouse, like Andrew Ball was talking about, you have no time to discuss anything. If you want to fuck, get in, get out. You know?
Just be quick. I mean, you're already quick with it anyway. I mean, some people just can't elongate.
Right, you give it the quick dick, and it's out and about. That's all we do. You know, why are we in the forest? I don't know, but you look kind of good. So, you know, I'm actually gonna roll with this one.
But this leads me to the next category, okay? There's these couples that always seem to, like, have sex in the most random places. I mean, you go into a forest where it's already dark. It's always dark. It's always gonna be dark. I mean, it's always gonna be night. It's perfect.
Bring a candle.
I mean, these kids think they can get away with just having sex on a tree without the killer knowing. He knows. He's stuff. I bet you he has like tons of surveillance cameras. I mean, dude, the Chainsaw Massacre got in the car in like 3 seconds right before the girl started it. What the hell do you think? These killers have technology. They must. And then you all gonna have sex right there when your boyfriend's back is turned. Always the boyfriend's back is turned. I've seen this. He's the first one to die, and what the hell? She's gonna scream there for 3 minutes, run. Oh no, of course, who can forget the favorite tripping? I mean, there's a twig, there's a rock, and then all things you pick high heels to run in. You're gonna pick it in a forest. I mean, for God's sakes.
Who goes to the woods in high heels?
Seriously. Tell me, I don't understand. And like, I mean, if you're running, you at least know where the twigs are coming. I mean, you have eyes. You can see sticks. Well, okay, it's night. Alright, I get it. You can't see everything. But at least, I mean, pick a trail that you know you can run in. There's always a trail in these forest reserves or something.
Right, yeah, they pick the most, like, bootlegged path where there's knockdown trees, boats, and like, abandoned cars.
Oh, no, let's go take the rowboat in the middle of the lake and do it. Rather than keep the boat close to the shore where we can easily escape. No. It's not like this killer can swim. I mean, Jason just drowned in a lake. I mean, that's how he died, yet he survived. I mean, come on. All he has to do is stab a hole in that, like, boat. You're sinking, then getting stabbed.
I don't even think Jason can swim. I think he walks on the bottom. He's just that gangster.
I mean, I give up to Jason. I mean, he's just that smart.
Because he don't look like he can do much of anything besides walk. Which brings me to my next point. How do these killers get around? How do they get to point A to point B so quick? Do they take public transportation? Do they have a car?
I believe so.
Do they rob somebody? They bike and then ride it? You know? Do they take a scooter? Do they fly? I don't know.
I'm starting to think these killers teleport. Because again, Chainsaw Massacre 2. How did this motherfucker get in the car before she did? And he was like what, 10 paces behind her? Yet she got in the car. Here he comes right out the back seat and then drills straight through her. I mean, I was still thinking about that one. That's the only killing movie I'm still questioning. I think that erased my brain more than Inception.
No, yeah, it's just the same movie. Same killer, amazing powers, I don't know what it is. Like, towards the end of the movie, you get the girl who jumps in the pickup truck or whatever. Drive for a good, you know, like 50 feet, you know, going 30 miles per hour at least, and then all you see from the corner of the screen is like a meat hook, and then
who can forget this?
Fucking Leatherface hooks her in the chest and jerks her out of the car.
I don't know.
He was training for the Olympics or something before they came. Well, you know, while he was chopping people's faces, he must have sprinted to each like station. To like beat his record, but because this guy was on some serious stuff. He had his Nikes on and everything. Because we don't know why they keep making movies like this. I mean, and a man of his size can't run that fast.
I mean, he must have got the new Nikes out or something. Like,
he must have been T-1000 in that ass.
Which leads me to my next. Okay, we already know, since we've talked about it, killers can get you when you're vulnerable, they're fast. They got some sort of transportation, they're smart, and then there's the stupid people who make fun of the killer. We have people in, like, with My Bloody Valentine. First thing the dude the girl runs into the mine, the dude pops out, tells her, like, oh, you think I was a killer? Bam! Pickaxe! Bam! 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 Pickaxe!
Load a whistle! Load a whistle!